Akram Jafar, and I'm your course director and instructor of the ANAT1010 course. This course is your first deep dive into the world of human anatomy. You will soon discover that studying anatomy is not about memorizing body parts, but it's about relating them to function and how they fit together to form the human body. In ANAT1010, we will explore everything related to the human body, from the microstructure of tissues to the complex systems that form our body, like the nervous system and the cardiovascular system. So enjoy the journey. This course runs on two platforms, Brightspace and WileyPLUS. Brightspace is your main hub where you'll find announcements, course content, and assessments. So think of it as the central nervous system of this course. Now here's how to get started. Log in to Brightspace via the Dalhousie University site. Then select ANAT1010 from the course list. Once inside, you'll land on the homepage where all the latest announcements live. So set up notifications to stay updated on the new posts. And for maximum efficacy, download the Pulse app to get course alerts directly on your phone. Next, head to the course outline, which is available under the course content. So this document should be your best friend. It outlines everything from the study schedules to grading policies. One of the key sections here is the study plan, and this will help you stay organized and on track. It is outlined in the course outline, and it is reflected on Brightspace. This study plan will help you align your studies with lecture topics, assignments, and assessments, ensuring you'll always be prepared. By following the plan, you will avoid last-minute cramming and balance your workload effectively. It also contains evaluation details, that's to say all the ways you will be graded from assignments to exams. Also, it contains important dates, so mark your calendar for midterms, final exams, and assignments deadlines. Next, move to PowerPoint lectures in the content. PowerPoint lectures. You'll find that our lectures are the backbone of this course. They are divided into three blocks. After each block, you will have a test. So block one is the general histology, integumentary and musculoskeletal systems. Block two is the nervous system and the endocrine system. And then block three is the cardiovascular, respiratory, lymphatic, digestive, urinary, and reproductive systems. Each lecture is provided as a PowerPoint file packed with animations, videos, and hyperlinked screencasts. So they are interactive, and you may download and view them in a slideshow mode to unlock all the features. So this is the slideshow mode here. I have downloaded the lecture, and you can see here that there are links to videos.
Clinical and anatomical terminology is mainly based on a Greek or
audio. This figure gives us a chance to practice some more of the terms used to describe.
And so on. Some lectures are paired with virtual anatomy videos where you'll see anatomical structures in details. For instance, this lecture here on the muscular system includes a lab video. So take notes and then tackle the self-assessment lab questions after watching the video. Back to the lecture, you will see that in addition to the screencast of the lecture, there is a related lab video and a related self-assessment questions on the upper limb muscles. So let's start with the related lab video here. They arise from the skull, the back of the skull. Also, they arise from the cervical vertebrae. And then we have the remaining part of the muscle, although it has been cut and dissected here. The remaining part of the muscle arises. After you watch the video, go to the related self-assessment questions. In this case, it's better to download the PowerPoint presentation. After downloading the presentation file, you in the slideshow mode, you will see here that there are blank boxes. And so you can just click on the black box to reveal the answer. Many of these lab images will appear in your exams, so don't skip them. Next up is WileyPLUS, and this is your secondary platform for weekly assignments. Go to assignments here. Not only the assignments, these are the weekly assignments. But if you scroll down, you will find that there are also adaptive practice assignments, and these are bonus assignments. The weekly plus assignments, they worth 20% of your final grade. Okay, you need to submit the assignments before the due date to avoid the 50% penalty. You see here that there are due dates attached to each of the assignments. Let's try one of the assignments. So this is the introduction assignment. You can see the availability, the due date. Click on it. There are 30 questions, 30 points. This is the content that is covered by the assignment, and then you start the assignment. So for example, here a system in the body is composed of related with a common function. So it is related organs. This is the correct answer. But as you can see here that there are two attempts allowed. So if you make an incorrect answer, let's make it an incorrect answer. So tissues, submit the answer. Here it says it's incorrect and it will give you here another attempt. So meanwhile, you have a link to the e-textbook and study. So this is the levels of organization and body systems. And you can see here that at the system level, the system consists of related organs. Okay, so now I will go back here and make the correct answer, organs, and then submit the answer. My answer is correct. So take advantage of these resources to make the most of your learning experience. When you are on WileyPLUS platform, you are not just completing assignments, you are also getting valuable tools to track your progress and enhance your learning. So you can go to the e-textbook directly, Wiley course resource, and then this is the e-textbook. You can go to the e-textbook, browse the chapters. You can add notes, you can copy text, you can listen. You can create flashcards. Also, don't forget to check your grades on the gradebook here. In addition to the required WileyPLUS weekly activities, there are also bonus activities, and these are two types of bonus activities. One of them is the adaptive practice assignments for extra credit, and these are available, as I have just mentioned, on WileyPLUS. So again, you go to the assignments, and then you will find adaptive practice assignments. So these are personalized quizzes that adapt to your strengths and weaknesses, and they provide a tailored learning experience. Unlike the Triweekly boosters, which I'm going to talk about in a moment, they are available until the day of the final examination. There is no due date, while the Triweekly boosters are only available on a specific day. So let's take, for example, the adaptive practice introduction assignment. Open the assignment. So this is will tell you get ready for the first adaptive practice assignment. You don't need to answer all the questions in order to score full mark. I will start the assignment. In which way are the hands directionally related to the elbows? So the hands are located distal to the elbow, and then submit the answer. You are correct. And then I continue. You can always watch your progress here. Now my progress is 10%. Then we continue. Now my score is 5 out of 10 points. So I can just stop now, come back later, or I can continue until I reach the 100%. And this will be achieved by getting a progress of 75% only. The other bonus activity that you find here is you find it in the content, Triweekly boosters. So these are available only for one day, which is the day of the scheduled lecture, between 3 maximum 6 questions. You need to answer them, and you will see that in the slides, in the PowerPoint slides, there is always an indication at some of the slides which give you the title of the question that you at that moment you will be able to answer. So these are the assignments. For example, this is the booster 1, booster 2 cells. So these are the number of the lecture and the title of the lecture. Also, you can access them from the PowerPoint lecture. So if here, for example, this is the lecture on introduction to basic human anatomy, you will find that there is here below in the details, you will find In addition to link to the screencast lecture, there is a link to the Triweekly assignments, so you can access it from here as well. Triweekly boosters and adaptive practice will help reinforce your learning and improve your final grade. However, you can only gain up to 5% extra credits. Even if you get 5% on Triweekly, 5% on adaptive practice, then the total bonus mark should not exceed extra credit. They complement each other. You can do them both. You can do either of them. Now let's talk about the exams. So we will go to the course content, then assessment. The exams are online exams. They are open book exams. There are three midterm exams and a final exam. Each midterm exam is in fact two quizzes. One of them is called midterm and the other is the lab test. They will be open for 2 days, 48 hours. Different types of questions are available. So there's multiple choice questions, multi-select, matching and ordering questions. Some of the questions are with pictures, others are without pictures. The best way to master these exams is to prepare your notes, to study before that, and also to do the practice tests. So there is, for example, here, practice midterm one. These practice tests will give you an idea about the type of questions that you are going to have in the exam, actual exam, going to start the quiz. This is a multiple choice question, which of the following are most numerous general connective tissue cells. So here, these are fibroblasts and next page. And then see here, this is a multi-select, select all choices that apply. In this case, there is a penalty for the incorrect answer. This gives you an indication that it is a practice test, so you will not be confused and you miss the actual test. Anyway, we will go back to the question. Joints that allow flexion and extension movements includes... show you another type of question here. So this is a kind of matching question. Match each of the following bony parts with the most appropriate feature. So the ulna doesn't have a coracoid process. The coracoid process is in the scapula. So I will select the scapula here. Has a coracoid process. The ulna is the medial bone of the forearm, so that would be number 6, while the radius is the bone that rotates during pronation and supination, so that would be number 4, and so on. You see that there is a timer here, so always check the timer, and then when you are done, you submit the quiz. It will give you warning if there are questions that are not answered, so you have to answer all the questions, and then you submit the quiz, and then after submitting the quiz, you will get your score, and also you will get, for about 2 minutes, you will have access to the correct answers of the incorrectly answered questions, okay? Let's do a lab test to see the difference between the midterm and the lab test. Start quiz. These questions, they are always accompanied by pictures. Again, it gives you an indication that this is a practice test. So the bone indicated by the pointer is called the, this is the pubis. Again, this is a multiple choice question. Many of these pictures are derived either from your lectures or from the self-assessment PowerPoint presentations, or they are screenshots from the dissection videos. So select all choices that apply. And this is a multi-select, so be careful. These types of questions, multi-select, usually there's a penalty for an incorrect answer. Let me show you another type of question. This is the matching question. Match each of the following descriptions with the appropriate numbered one. So which one is a metatarsal bone? That should be number 5 is a metatarsal bone. Lateral bone of the leg, go up a little bit. And lateral bone of the leg is not number 2, it is this one. So it is 3, and then next, and so on. So all these questions, they are accompanied by pictures. So the practice tests are available on Brightspace. They are a fantastic way to prepare for your midterms and final examination. And the best part of it is that they won't count toward your grade. So there's no pressure in doing them and you can do them several times. So always do them before the exam to familiarize yourself with the types of questions you will encounter and refine your test-taking strategies. They are good to build confidence and ensure you are ready for the real exam. Another way to support your learning is by using flashcards. I have prepared Anki flashcards. Each flashcard offers a question with justifications for the correct answer and explanation for the incorrect ones. And also, you will find that these flashcards, they link to videos on Human Anatomy Education YouTube channel, providing deeper dives into specific topics. So you can go here and the contents, go to the flashcards and download these files. You will see that they have titles that are the same as the titles of the lectures. And each one of these files contains up to 20 questions. And follow the instructions here on how to install the Anki and upload these files to Anki again. For more interactive learning experience, you can follow the Human Anatomy Education Facebook page, and it is packed with anatomy trivia, humor, and extra resources. You can use the hashtag ANAT1010 or hashtag Block 1, Block 2, Block 3 to filter content specific to your course. Please note that the page does not replace the lectures and participation is optional. The students, they are not graded on their engagement on the page. A point should be mentioned about the usage of artificial intelligence. So while these tools are strictly prohibited during examinations and for completing assignments, they can be invaluable resource when used appropriately to enhance your learning experience. I have provided you with examples here and these links to videos on how to use them for that purpose. If you require accommodations, reach out to the Student Accessibility Center. I'm also here to help, so email me or book a virtual consultation through Collaborate Ultra. You can go to the course content, then course room, and then here, Collaborate Ultra, join the course room. This is the same place where you can join the course room for live question and answer forums. These are opportunities to ask questions, clarify any doubts, and get real-time guidance. So you may use the frequently asked questions link here. Probably you will get some answers to your questions. It'd be a good idea to take the tour of the course. This is like a quiz that will ensure that you are familiar with the course regarding the resources, schedules, examinations, questions. It will not be counted to your final course grade, but even the questions that are answered incorrectly by you, you will get the correct answer after you take the tour of the course quiz. Yeah, so that's it for now. I'm thrilled to have you in the ANAT1010, and I can't wait to explore the wonders of the human body with you. So let's make this semester both fun and productive. Thank you.